Myself Muzammil.
Myself Mantish.
Myself Shams.
Myself Rakshita.
Myself Priyanka.
Myself Namita.
Myself
Sahana. Myself Safa Sultan.
Myself Sanchita.
Myself Sanchi.
Myself Mallika.
Myself Pankaja.
Myself Manjushri.
Myself Reshma.
Everyone, attention here. India is the biggest democracy in the world. A free and fair elections are needed for a healthy democracy. In order to ensure free and independent elections in India, the part 15th of the constitution speaks about independent election commission in India from articles 324 to 329. It has a responsibility to conduct both central and state election. The election commission conducts local body elections under the article 324K. The article 324 speaks about formation of election commission. The Indian election commission was founded in January 25th, 1950. In the beginning, it had only one chief election commissioner. Hence, along with the chief election commissioner, two more election commissioners were appointed. In the year 1990, the two posts of two election commissioners were abolished. In the year 1993, the post of two election commissioners were created. All the three election commissioners enjoyed equal powers.
The election commissioner is appointed by the president. His tenure is of 6 years and retirement age is of 65 years. He can resign his job at every year of his age. The election commission conducts the elections of president, vice president, Raj Sabha, Lok Sabha, Vidhana Parishad and Vidhana Sabha. It has absolute powers to declare the dates of election, the result of election at any point of the election. This period is known as model code of conduct. The election commission has no employees of its own and it appoints the government employees by the approval of president. The state election commissioner has been appointed by the governor. He conducts the elections of local panchayat bodies and urban panchayat bodies. The election commission of Karnataka has been established under the article 308 of Karnataka. He conducts the elections of local bodies. My friend Priyanka, she will give information about voting.
The first election procedure is constituencies. The state is divided into small electoral divisions for the purpose of elections. These small electoral divisions are called constituencies. Constituencies are formed on the basis of population. Constituencies are of two types. One is Lok Sabha constituencies and another is Legislative Assembly constituencies. The members elected from the Lok Sabha constituency become the member of Lok Sabha and they are called MPs. Similarly, the members elected from the Legislative Assembly become the member of Legislative Assembly constituency and they are called MLAs. In both these constituencies, reservation is provided to scheduled castes and scheduled tribes and they are called reserved constituencies. Next, my friend Namita will continue the next election procedure, it is voters list.
The voter list is the list which contains the names and certain other details of the voters. It is also known as electoral roll. Electoral roll is also under the age of 18 are included and the dead or deleted names. Electoral roll photo identity cards are issued to all eligible voters by the election commission by the voters and proof such as Aadhaar card is issued by the election commission. Next, my friend Sana will continue the election procedure, that is notification.
Notification. The election process begins with the notification. The details scheduled or timetable of the election
nomination of the candidate. As we know, as is the democracy, people have the right to elect and people have the right to contest. The candidates who wish to contest with certain conditions and file their nomination papers. Some people should also deposit few amount of money as security deposit with the nomination papers. The political party choose the candidates to represent the party. Many of the time, the party ticket have proven to give a good number of votes from the voter. The candidates who are not identified with any political party are called as independent party. Such independent parties are allotted symbols to the election commission.
Did you see? The first procedure is to submit the nomination form to the officer. Like this, every individual submits his nomination form. Let me call my friend Sanchita. She will give information about
scrutiny. The eligible candidates are given time limit to withdraw their nomination papers if they desire. Now I would like to call my friend Sanchi to discuss about the further election system.
Election campaign. The election campaign starts after the announcement of the finalists of the candidates. Election campaign ends before the 48 hours of the closure of election. Here the candidates give several programs, promises to the people fulfill if they vote to a power. Like public meetings, door-to-door campaign, pamphlets, flags and the slogans are common during this propaganda. All the candidates are given the common code by the election commission.
Do you have curiosity to see an election campaign? This is how our election campaign is started.
Mandadunge
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 Imma
Matayarige
Mandadunge
Imma Matayarige
Mandadunge
Nama Sankhe Mooru
Manerala Neeru
Nama Sankhe Mooru
Manerala Neeru
Nama Sankhe Mooru
Manerala Neeru
Mandadunge Mata
Vesanke Ita
Mandadunge Mata
Vesanke Ita
Mandadunge Mata
Vesanke Ita
Ella Nanna Mata Bandavare ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ನೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಮನೆ ಮಗನಾದ ಮಾಂತೇಶ್ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಅಮೂಲ್ಯವಾದ ಮತವನ್ನು ನನಗೆ ನೀಡಿ ಕ್ರಮ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಮೂರು ನೀರು ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಗುರುತು. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಮತ ನನಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಅಮೂಲ್ಯವಾದದ್ದು. ಎಲ್ಲ ಮತ ಬಾಂಧವರು ಮತದಾನ ದಿನದಂದು ನನ್ನ ಗುರುತಿಗೆ ಮತವನ್ನು ಹಾಕುವುದನ್ನು ಮರೆಯಬೇಡಿ. ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಹೇಳಿ, ಕ್ರಮ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಮೂರು
to vote. In the polling booths, the ballot papers are provided to voters
voters to cast their votes. EVMs means electronic voting machines are replacing the ballot papers nowadays. The voters click the button on the electronic voting machine and after the election it will be seized and taken to the counting center. This is we call electronic voting machine.
Now let us see the process of voting. The first procedure is to show their identity card, whether it be Aadhaar card or PAN card or voter ID. The second procedure is to apply ink on the index finger. Like this, everyone gives their vote line by line and a person could give only one vote. All citizens need to clarify their identity card. If it is invalid, they are not allowed to vote. The next procedure is of counting day. Now let me call my friend Pankaja. She will give information about counting.
Counting of votes is done in the counting center by the counting officials in the presence of the candidates and their agents. Counting votes has become very easy and quick by the introduction of electro voting machine. Under certain special circumstances, recounting is permitted. In case of any disputes, the candidates can approach the court of law. Returning officer declares the result at the end of the counting day.
Not said anything, you know? Both the concepts are good. Yesterday's that the New Year concept and then like this. But before that, they are yet they are not perfect expressing their concept, isn't it? That's why this time the best performance will be given to A and B section both. A section and B section both will be considered for, because that concept is entirely different. That has entertainment. This is entirely opposite. That is entertainment. This is totally fighting. That's why both A section and B section students will be declared equally. Okay? Thank you.